Please rise.
And we pray in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen. Amen.
Peace be with you.
Amen.
So it's a joy to be with you tonight as we enter into these most sacred days of the liturgical year, and as we celebrate tonight this Mass of the Lord's Supper. Let us open our hearts to the miracle in which we participate, and we begin by acknowledging our need for a Redeemer, a Messiah. We ask for his mercy and grace. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my fault. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore I ask Blessed Mary ever, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to Lord. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Oh.
Let us pray. O God, who have called us to participate in this most sacred supper, in which your only begotten Son, when about to hand himself over to death, entrusted to the church a sacrifice new for all eternity, the banquet of his love, grant, we pray, that we may draw from so great a mystery the fullness of charity and of life. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
A reading from the book of Exodus. The Lord said to Moses and Aaron in the land of Egypt, "This month shall stand at the head of your calendar. You shall reckon it the first month of the year. Tell the whole community of Israel, on the 10th of this month, every one of your families must procure for itself a lamb, one apiece for each household. If a family is too small for a whole lamb, it shall join the nearest household in procuring one and shall share the lamb in proportion to the number of persons who partake of it. The lamb must be a year old male without blemish. You may take it from either the sheep or the goats. You shall keep it until the 14th day of the month, and then with the whole assembly of Israel present, it shall be slaughtered during the evening twilight. They shall take some of its blood and apply it to the two doorposts and the lintel of every house in which they partake of the lamb. That same night they shall eat its roasted flesh with unleavened bread and bitter herbs. This is how you are to eat it, with your loins girt, sandals on your feet, and your staff in hand. You shall eat like those who are in flight. It is the Passover of the Lord. For on this same night I will go through Egypt, striking down every firstborn of the land, both man and beast, and executing judgment on all the gods of Egypt, I, the Lord. But the blood will mark the houses where you are. Seeing the blood, I will pass over you. Thus, when I strike the land of Egypt, no destructive blow will come upon you. This day shall be a memorial feast for you, with all your generations shall celebrate, with pilgrimage to the Lord as a perpetual institution." The word of the Lord.
For me. blessing cup is the communion with the blood of Christ.
Lectura de la primera carta del apóstol San Pablo a los Corintios. Hermanos, yo recibí del Señor lo mismo que les he transmitido, que el Señor Jesús, la noche en que iba a ser entregado, tomó pan en sus manos y pronunciando la acción de gracias, lo partió y dijo: esto es mi cuerpo, que se entrega por ustedes. Hagan esto en memoria mía. Lo mismo hizo con el cáliz después de cenar, diciendo: este cáliz es la nueva alianza que se sella con mi sangre. Hagan esto en memoria mía siempre que beban de él. Por eso, cada vez que ustedes comen de este pan y beben de este cáliz, proclaman la muerte del Señor hasta que vuelva. Palabra de Dios.
Te alabamos, Señor.
Be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Before the feast of the Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to pass from this world to the Father. He loved his own in the world, and he loved them to the end. The devil had already induced Judas, son of Simon the Iscariot, to hand him over. So, during supper, fully aware that the Father had put everything into his power, and that he had come from God and was returning to God, he rose from supper and took off his outer garments. He took a towel and tied it around his waist. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and dry them with a towel around his waist. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Master,
"Are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered and said to him, "What am I doing? You do not understand now, but you will understand later." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered him, "Unless I wash you, you will have no inheritance with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Master, then only not my feet, but my hands and head as well." Jesus said to him, "Whoever has bathed has no need except to have his feet washed, for he is clean all over. But so you are clean, but not all." For he knew who would betray him. For this reason, he said, "Not all of you are clean." So when he had washed their feet and put his garments back on and reclined at table again, he said to them, "Do you realize what I have done for you? You call me teacher and master, and rightly so, for indeed I am. If I, therefore, the master and teacher, have washed your feet, you ought to wash one another's feet. I have given you a model to follow, so that as I have done for you, you should also do." Antes de la fiesta de Pascua, sabiendo Jesús que había llegado a la hora de pasar de este mundo al Padre, y habiendo amado a los suyos que estaban en el mundo, los amó hasta el extremo. En el transcurso de la cena, cuando ya el diablo había puesto en el corazón de Judas Iscariote, hijo de Simón, la idea de entregarlo, Jesús, consciente de que el Padre había puesto en sus manos todas las cosas y sabiendo que había salido de Dios y a Dios volvía, se levantó de la mesa, se quitó el manto y tomando una toalla se la ciñó. Luego echó agua en una jofaina y se puso a lavarle los pies a los discípulos y a secárselos con la toalla que se había ceñido. Cuando llegó a Simón Pedro, este le dijo, "Señor, ¿me vas a lavar tú a mí los pies?" Jesús le replicó, "Lo que estoy haciendo tú no lo entiendes ahora, pero lo comprenderás más tarde." Pedro le dijo, "Tú no me lavarás los pies jamás." Jesús le contestó, "Si no te lavo, no tendrás parte conmigo." Entonces le dijo Simón Pedro, "En este caso, Señor, no solo los pies, sino también las manos y la cabeza." Jesús le dijo, "El que se ha bañado no necesita lavarse más que los pies, porque todo él está limpio, y ustedes están limpios, aunque no todos." Como sabía quién lo iba a entregar, por eso dijo, "No todos están limpios." Cuando acabó de lavarle los pies, se puso otra vez el manto, volvió a la mesa y les dijo, "¿Comprenden lo que acabo de hacer con ustedes? Ustedes me llaman maestro y señor, y dicen bien, porque lo soy. Pues si yo, que soy el maestro y el señor, les he lavado los pies, también ustedes deben lavarle los pies los unos a los otros. Les he dado el ejemplo para que lo que yo he hecho con ustedes, también ustedes lo hagan." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Again, it's a joy to be with you tonight. And tonight we enter into the most sacred days of our liturgical year. We begin the solemn celebration of these days with the Mass of the Lord's Supper. In tonight's liturgy, We transport ourselves in prayer to the upper room of Jerusalem, where Jesus celebrated the ancient Passover meal with his apostles. The Passover meal for Jews in Jesus' time and still today is a commemoration and celebration of the meal that began the great liberation of the Israelites from their enslavement in Egypt. It was a meal that gave the Israelites their ethnic and spiritual identity. The main course of the meal featured a year-old lamb whose blood splashed on the lintels of their doors, protected that household from the angel of death. The menu also included unleavened bread because it was a meal to be prepared in haste so that they were ready at a moment's notice to flee the place of their slavery. Jesus transformed the Passover into a new meal of liberation that the Second Vatican Council identified as the source and summit of our Catholic faith and spiritual life. John the Baptist identified Jesus as the Lamb of God who liberates us from the enslavement to sin and its consequence, death. This last Passover for Jesus with his disciples would also be the first Eucharist, the first Mass. In effect, Jesus was ordaining the priest, empowering the apostles to celebrate this new meal of liberation for the new Israel, the church. Our Lord was giving his disciples the power to make present for his disciples throughout all time the great sacrifice of Calvary. Jesus was giving to the church the bread of life and the cup of salvation that nourishes his disciples on their journey through this world to the ultimate land, promised land of heaven. The Gospels of Matthew, Mark, and Luke, as well as the epistles of St. Paul, give us the words that Jesus spoke at the Last Supper over what had been just ordinary bread and wine, transforming them into his real presence, his flesh and blood. St. John provides his explanation of the real presence of Jesus in the Eucharist earlier in his gospel. The day after he had multiplied the loaves and fish to feed thousands of people, crowds of people were pursuing Jesus, seeking physical bread that he had provided only the day before. It is here that John gives the most comprehensive teaching in the entire New Testament on the Lord's real presence in the Eucharist. Jesus admonishes the crowd for feverishly seeking physical bread. Our Lord declares, "I am the bread of life. Whoever comes to me will never hunger, and whoever believes in me will never thirst." We are told that the people murmured about Jesus describing himself as the bread of life. This is similar to the people of the Old Testament who murmured against Moses because they were tired of the manna God had provided for their journey. Jesus does not soften his teaching. Instead, our Lord doubles down, declaring, "I am the bread of life. Your ancestors ate manna in the desert, but they died. This is the bread that comes down from heaven, so that the one may eat it and not die. I am the living bread that came down from heaven. Whoever eats this bread will live forever, and the bread that I will give is my flesh for the life of the world." John tells us that the Jews began quarreling among themselves. Many thought Jesus was insane. They thought this was crazy talk. Jesus again does not retract or even attempt to soften what he had said, but instead speaks even more plainly and emphatically. "Amen, amen, I say to you, unless you eat the flesh of the Son of Man and drink his blood, you do not have life within you. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood has eternal life, and I will raise him on the last day. For my flesh is true food, and my blood is true drink. Whoever eats my flesh and drinks my blood remains in me, and I in him. Jesus tells us that many of his disciples, John tells us that many of Jesus' disciples said, "This is a hard saying." John relates, as a result of this, many of the disciples returned to their former way of life and no longer accompanied him. What does Jesus do? The Lord does not say, "Wait, wait, I was just speaking metaphorically, symbolically. You're taking me too literally." No, instead, Jesus turns to the 12 and asks, "Do you also want to leave?" Then Peter, in one of his shining moments, replies for the 12 apostles by saying, "Master, to whom shall we go? You have the words of eternal life. We have come to believe and are convinced that you are the Holy One of God." Peter and the other apostles really had no idea what Jesus meant when he described himself as the bread of life, or what he meant when he told the crowds that they must eat his flesh and drink his blood. They could not understand the depth of the meaning of this teaching until experiencing Holy Thursday and Good Friday. However, they trusted Jesus, even if they did not comprehend the meaning of his words. On Holy Thursday, Jesus gave his disciples a meal of liberation. The Eucharist is a sacred meal in which God shares his own life with us. And through the Blessed Sacrament, our Lord wants to provide us with the nourishment that can give us the strength to follow him along the path of heroic love. St. John's description of the Last Supper features Jesus washing the feet of his apostles. And in so doing, our Lord models authentic love. This true love, exemplified by Jesus throughout his ministry, does not seek to use another for our pleasure, but rather seeks to serve the other, seek for the good of the other. The Mass is also a sacrifice, because through the liturgy, we not only are transported to the upper room, because at every Mass, our Lord's sacrifice on Calvary is also made present to us. Every Mass gives us the opportunity to be present at the foot of the cross. Jesus chose to surrender himself to his passion and crucifixion, not to satisfy some bloodthirst of a vengeful God the Father. The rebellion of our first parents, the original sin, resulted in the suffering that inevitably flows when we seek to be our own God. Jesus chose to reverse Adam's disobedience by his obedience to his identity as the Word made flesh, the second person of the triune God, the beloved Son of the Father. One of the windows in our sanctuary depicts Abraham being prevented by God's angel from sacrificing his beloved only son, Isaac. What God would never require from us, we require from God. Jesus immersed himself in our sin-fractured humanity so that he could reveal the depth of God's love and mercy for us. When we attend Mass, we should always be aware that we are touching Calvary. We should also bring whatever suffering is present in our lives and unite our suffering with the perfect sacrifice of Calvary. During the offertory at Mass, we should not just place our envelope in the collection basket, though if our support of our parish is truly sacrificial, then it is part of what we bring to the altar. But we should call to mind all of the difficulties, adversities, and suffering in our lives so that we can unite it during the consecration to Jesus' perfect gift of himself on Calvary. Bishop Robert Barron, in his booklet, This Is My Body, describes how our suffering can be transformed by uniting our adversities with our Lord's supreme sacrifice. Bishop Barron proposes that we can look upon our pain simply as dumb suffering, or we could see it through the lens provided by the sacrificial death of Jesus, appreciating it as the means by which God is drawing us closer to himself. Suffering, once joined to the cross of Jesus, can become the vehicle for the reformation of the sinful self, the turning of the soul in the direction of love. We celebrate this Mass of the Lord's Supper this Holy Thursday in the midst of this three-year Eucharistic revival pastoral initiative for the Catholic Church in the United States. May we open our hearts to the miracle of the Eucharist in which we are privileged to participate. Jesus desires to come to us tonight and feed us again with his flesh, the bread of life. And our Lord wants to nourish us so that we can follow him along the path of unconditional and uncompromising love. Jesus wants each of us to live in such a way that we draw others, not to ourselves, but to Jesus Christ, who desires to make us a tabernacle of his real presence in the world. Amen.
Mis pies, Señor, lava mi alma, lava mis pies, Señor, para ser digno de ti. Quiero lavar tus pies en mis hermanos. Cena, te quitas el manto, preparas el agua y te arrodillas frente a mí. Me miras tan dulce y lleno de amor, tomas mis pies y lavas mis pecados. Hermanos, quiero imitar tu amor, viviendo para servir. Yo te pregunto, Señor, ¿me vas a lavar los pies a mí? Y me contestas tiernamente, tú ahora no comprender lo que yo estoy haciendo, lo comprenderás después. Lava mis pies, Señor, lava mi alma, lava mis mis pies, Señor, para ser digno de ti. Quiero lavar tus pies en mis hermanos. Quiero imitar tu amor, viviendo para servir.
Please stand. With grateful hearts and confidence, let us approach our Heavenly Father, asking for those things that we need as we strive to follow Jesus in the way of servant love.
We pray for the church on earth, that we may come to greater belief in the real presence of the Lord in the Blessed Sacrament. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Por todos los que ocupan posiciones de poder e influencia en el mundo, para que puedan descubrir una mayor comprensión del perfecto amor y servicio de Cristo, roguemos al Señor.
Awesome.
For those confronted by temptation, that they may be strengthened by the example of Christ's loyalty to his Father, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Por la parroquia de la Anunciación en Baldwin City, por nuestra parroquia hermana, la Iglesia de la Natividad en Leawood, y por todos nuestros hermanos y hermanas en la arquidiócesis, para que profundicen su fe en el Señor y escuchen su llamado a seguirlo. Roguemos al Señor.
Rogamos al Señor.
For all those who have died, that they may enter into eternal life, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Por la intención de esta misa, que es por todos los sacerdotes de la arquidiócesis, oremos al Señor.
Rogamos, Señor.
For all the intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts, and for all the intentions on our parish prayer line, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for giving us your Son, Jesus, and for calling us to be his brothers and sisters, and sharing with his very life with us. We ask you to help us to follow his way of servant love. We pray this in his name, Jesus, who is Lord forever and ever.
Amen. Deus ibi est, congregavit nos in unum Christi amor, exultemus et in ipso jucundemur, timeamus et amemus Deum vivum, et ex quode diligamus nos sincero. Ubi caritas et amor Deus ibi est.
Con tu sangre sana todas mis heridas, escucha mi voz y háblame,
háblame.
Quiero entregarme entero, ofrecerte vida y alma y decirte que te quiero de verdad. Escúchame, sentir de nuevo un viento cálido
sonreír y entregarte todos mis problemas, volver a ser feliz. Escúchame. Dame tu pan, tu vino, que alimenta mi alma enferma, que vive en anhelo de verdad.
Oh, Señor,
dame de esa agua que me da la vida eterna y dime que siempre me amarás. Todas mis heridas, escucha mi voz y háblame.
Háblame.
Quiero entregarme entero, ofrecerte vida y alma y decirte que te quiero de verdad. Escúchame. Sonreír y entregarte todos mis problemas, volver a ser feliz. Escúchame.
My sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God the Father Almighty.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and good of all of his holy church.
Grant us, O Lord, we pray, that we may participate worthily in these mysteries. For whenever the memorial of this sacrifice is celebrated, the work of our redemption is accomplished through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he is the true and eternal priest who instituted the pattern of an everlasting sacrifice and was the first to offer himself as the saving victim, commanding us to make this offering as his memorial. As we eat his flesh that was sacrificed for us, we are made strong. And as we drink his blood that was poured out for us, we are washed clean. And so with the angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the host and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Sanctus, Sanctus, Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plenis sunt celi et terra, gloria tua, hosanna in excelsis, benedictus.
To you, therefore, most merciful Father, we make humble prayer and petition through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, that you accept and bless these gifts, these offerings, these holy and unblemished sacrifices, which we offer you firstly for your holy Catholic Church. Be pleased to grant her peace, to guard, unite, and govern her throughout the whole world, together with your servant Francis, our Pope, and me, your unworthy servant, James Patrick, our Archbishop Emeritus, and all those who, holding to the truth, hand on the Catholic and Apostolic faith.
Acuérdate, Señor, de tus hijos y de todos los que aquí reunidos, cuya fe entrega bien conoces, por ellos y todos los suyos, por perdón de sus pecados y la salvación que esperan. Te ofrecemos y ellos mismos te ofrecen este sacrificio de alabanza a ti, eterno Dios, vivo y verdadero.
Reunidos en comunión con toda la Iglesia para celebrar el día santo en que nuestro Señor Jesucristo fue entregado por nosotros, veneramos la memoria ante todo de la gloriosa siempre Virgen María, Madre de Jesucristo nuestro Dios y Señor, la de su esposo San José, la de los santos apóstoles y mártires, Pedro y Pablo, Andrés, Santiago y Juan, Tomás, Santiago, Felipe, Bartolomé, Mateo, Simón y Tadeo, Lino, Cleto, Clemente, Sixto, Cornelio, Cipriano, Lorenzo, Crisógono, Juan y Pablo, Cosme, Damián, y la de todos los santos. Por sus méritos y oraciones, concédenos en todo tu protección.
Therefore, Lord, we pray, graciously accept this oblation of our service and that of your whole family, which we make to you as we observe the day on which our Lord Jesus Christ handed on the mysteries of his body and blood for his disciples to celebrate. Order our days in your peace and command that we be delivered from eternal damnation and counted among the flock of those you have chosen. Be pleased, O God, we pray, to bless, acknowledge, and approve this offering in every respect. Make it spiritual and acceptable, so that it may become for us the body and blood of your most beloved Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. On the day before he was to suffer, for our salvation and the salvation of all, that is today, He took bread in his holy and venerable hands, and with eyes raised to heaven to you, O God, his almighty Father, giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took this precious chalice in his holy and venerable hands, and once more giving you thanks, he said the blessing and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Mortem tua, annunciamus Domine, et tua resurrectionem confitemur, Domine, venias.
Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the Blessed Passion, the resurrection from the dead, and the glorious ascension into heaven of Christ your Son, our Lord, we, your servants and your holy people, offer to your glorious majesty from the gifts you have given us this pure victim, this holy victim, this spotless victim, the holy bread of eternal life, and the chalice of everlasting salvation. Be pleased to look upon these offerings with a serene and kindly countenance, and to accept them as once you were pleased to accept the gifts of your servant Abel the just, the sacrifice of Abraham, our father in faith, and the offering of your high priest Melchizedek, a holy sacrifice, a spotless victim. In humble prayer, we ask you, Almighty God, command that these gifts be borne by the hands of your holy angel to your altar on high, in the sight of your divine majesty, so that all of us who through this participation at the altar receive the most holy body and blood of your Son may be filled with every grace and heavenly blessing.
Acuérdate también, Señor, de tus hijos que nos han precedido con el signo de la fe y duermen al sueño de la paz. A ellos, Señor, y a cuantos descansen en Cristo, concédeles el lugar del consuelo, de la luz y de la paz.
Aceptemos en su compañía, no por nuestros méritos, sino conforme a tu bondad, por Cristo, Señor nuestro. Y a nosotros, pecadores, siervos tuyos, que confiamos en tu infinita misericordia, admítidos en la asamblea de los santos apóstoles y mártires, Juan el Batista, Esteban, Matías, Bernabé, Ignacio, Alejandro, Marcelino y Pedro, Felicidad y Perpetua, Águeda, Lucía, Inés, Cecilia, Anastasia, y de todos los santos, aceptamos en su compañía, no por nuestros méritos, sino conforme a tu voluntad, por Cristo, Señor nuestro.
Through whom you continue to make all these good things, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
qui es in celis, sanctificetur nomen tuum, adveniat regnum tuum, fiat voluntas tua, sicut in cielo et in terra. Panem nostrum quotidianum da nobis hodie, et dimitte nobis debita nostra, sicut et nos dimittibus debitoribus nostris, et ne nos inducas in tentationem, sed libera nos a malo.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other this sign of peace.
Peace, Anthony, John, peace, thanks. Peace, Michael, peace, thanks. Mike, peace, thanks. Peace, Mike, thanks.
Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Agnus Dei, qui tollis peccata mundi, miserere nobis.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed.
This is my body, which is given up for you. This is the cup of the new covenant in my blood.
partake thereof, do it in memory of me.
Doce hombres y el maestro, doce panes y la vida, doce copas y la alianza se mezclaban aquel día. Enseñaba lo que es la vida, donde Jesús derramando su sangre les perdonaba su maldad divina. Eucaristía,
muchos hombres, el maestro, muchos panes, una vida, muchas copas, una alianza, se comparte.
Let us pray. Grant, Almighty God, that just as we are renewed by the supper of your Son in this present age, so we may enjoy his banquet for all eternity, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Amen.
Just one brief announcement. Thank you to all of you for joining us this evening. We are going to now process with the Blessed Sacrament through the church, the archbishop, the deacons, priests, and servers. And we'll be chanting as we do the procession. And you are welcome to stay in the church after the procession concludes, but we do ask when you leave that you leave in a reverent silence to observe our Lord's being arrested and taken to the high priest, to Caiaphas's home in prison. So you're welcome to stay. The church will be open until about 11 p.m. You're welcome to stay in the church and pray to be with our Lord. He'll be in the tabernacle here, the altar of repose. But when you do leave, please leave in a reverent silence. Muchas gracias a todos ustedes por venir, por estar con nosotros esta noche. Vamos a mantener la iglesia abierta hasta las 11 de la noche de esta noche, disponible para todos ustedes si quieren quedarse para rezar con el Señor. Vamos ahora a hacer una procesión por la iglesia, moviendo al Señor, transmitiéndolo desde el santuario hasta este sagrario. Y pues están, todos ustedes están invitados a quedarse por toda la noche hasta las 11, pero cuando salgan, por favor, les ruego que salgan en un silencio reverente para conmemorar que el Señor ahora es tomado un cautivo. ¿Okay? Pues muchas gracias y tenemos el Vía Crucis viviente al mediodía mañana, seguido por una liturgia, la liturgia con el arzobispo a las 3 de la tarde. We have our Living Stations of the Cross tomorrow at noon. Everyone is welcome to join us for that, followed by the Good Friday liturgy at 3 p.m. here in the church. Thank you so much.
sacramentally.